Hello everyone, good day. I'm Dr. Mohana Priya. Welcome to Dental Shots. So in this video we are going to see about the global immune deficiency acting as a risk factor of COVID-19 vaccines. So what is global immune deficiency? So you would have heard about many deficiencies like HIV, human immunodeficiency, but it's not related. It's not that I'm speaking about. The global immune deficiency is named so because the immune deficiency, which is prevalent globally. What are the sets of criteria for that? For example, if a person is an elderly person, definitely the immune deficiency will be there. And obese patients, patients who are suffering from type 2 diabetes mellitus and metabolic syndrome, immune related cancers, nutritional deficiencies and genetic alterations. So these set of people are suffering from immune deficiency. Hence, it is also prevalent globally. Hence, it is called as global immune deficiency. So these sets of people are a risk factor of COVID-19 vaccines. Why so? Because these people, as I said before, are having a weak antigen recognition. For example, they have a very, either it may be a virus or a bacteria, they have a weak antigen recognition. They cannot recognize the antigen which is coming from outside. And also, they have decrease in the quantity of immune cells. The number of immune cells is very less in above mentioned people. And also, quality, not only quantity, the quality, that is the functioning of the immune cell, is also decreased in these people. And the humoral immunity, the antibody response, is also less. Decreased humoral immunity and decreased initiation of the cellular response. That is also, cellular immunity is also low. And they have the memory cell disorders. So once it is infected, the body tends to have the memory cells and defense against the microorganism in a better way. But these kind of people will have a memory cell disorder too. So hence, the global immune deficiency is acting as a risk factor of COVID-19 vaccines. And coming to the vaccine manufacturing and regulation, the vaccine manufacturing involves several steps, several quality control steps, where hundreds of millions of doses needs to be manufactured. For example, if we come up with a positive COVID vaccines, the next difficulty we face is that we have to manufacture millions of doses for the vaccination purpose, mass vaccination purpose. So in that time, each vaccine which is being manufactured should be consistent in quality. The consistency in quality has to be maintained, and it requires how we have to find it, whether it is consistent or not in quality. We have to do a repeated testing of various batches of vaccine. The vaccines will be manufactured in different batches, so each batch should be repeatedly tested for the quality. And then most of the time what happens earlier, some batches of vaccines fail to have that quality stability. Hence, we don't know what is the reason. For unknown reason, some batches of vaccines fail to achieve the quality consistency. So coming to the vaccine regulation, before even any vaccine is getting approved for the general use, the agencies, if it's for Europe, it's like European Medical Agency and Food and Drug Administration, FDA, has to approve. Or any regulatory agencies of that particular country, respective country, will oversee the entire vaccine development process. Then only it will come to the general practice. Okay, the next is that why we should need any sufficient time for the development of vaccine. For example, if you would have heard about RSV, that is respiratory syncytial virus. For this virus, there have been research going on for nearly 50 years. But till date, there is no vaccine which has been developed against this RSV. So, despite 50 years of the research, they didn't have any vaccine for this RSV. So, many groups of vaccine like this will enter the clinical trials. Even the COVID-19 vaccines will enter the COVID clinical trials. But we really don't know whether it will satisfy the safety and efficacy. For this particular two reasons, most of the vaccines are getting rejected. That is, the clinical trials will be okay, but it fails to satisfy the clinical efficacy and clinical safety. Hence, a sufficient time is needed to prove any proposed vaccine, whether it is safe and effective, because it has to produce a synthesis of antibody. We have to check and what type of vaccine, what is the concentration we have to give, what is the dosage we have to give. Sometimes certain vaccines will give a strong immune response, so that one dose is enough, or else we have to give a booster dose. Everything has to be checked, and for this definitely sufficient time is needed to check the efficacy and safety, as well as to manufacture millions of doses for the mass population. Okay, so we will meet you in the next part of COVID vaccine series. If you like the video, kindly subscribe to the channel and have a great day. Thank you.